Might have been 18 pit stops.
Oh. I don't think they've been in that much drama.
16.
Okay. So yeah, there's
16 on lap races.
We'll have to look on live timing for that, because the actual...
And it's really easy, if you have small damage, you lose top speed, and there's no point continuing.
Oh, have we lost the broadcast?
Yeah, it's gone.
Well, I'm getting poked, I'm afraid. I need to go and babysit Andre for a minute.
Okay, go on, Mum.
Good luck for the rest of the broadcast. Hope everything works, and you guys are doing a great job.
Thank you.
Bye. We've lost the broadcast. We're going to have to rejoin in spectator mode, which is going to be a bit of a drama. We've disconnected.
Oh no!
No, it's back up now, it looks like. Yeah, we've got... The time is counting down.
Yeah, but the race...
We've been kicked from the server.
I can't see any of that, obviously. No.
So, we'll get back going in spectator mode. I don't know if someone else can get in and sort it out, or maybe we might have to come away and come back in a 2 or 3 seconds time or something, but I've got the whole RRD viewers died on me, so I would say that it's a disconnection their end and it's a disaster, so... Not to worry. Are we actually even broadcasting at all?
Yeah, it looks like the SRTV camera thing is still on there, but it's in a fixed position on the Mulsanne.
Yes.
SRTV.
Okay. If I jump to Flyer, then... Oh no, it won't even let me do that. It's very... let me come out of RRD and go back in. Right. Okay, thank you, Jonas. We are still broadcasting. We will do radio show for the next couple of minutes while we just sort out what's gone on with the field, and if we can get it back going again in spectator mode, we certainly will do, because it looks as though everything is completely frozen on the broadcast camera. Oh, there we go, back to Flyer. There we go, loving that. Yeah, I'd say we've got... Ah, there we go! It's now got back down the counting camera again, okay. I don't know how it can suddenly be counting down.
Nothing here.
This makes no sense whatsoever.
Well, for a 12-hour race, having this few technical issues isn't too bad, to be honest.
Yeah,
I can edit on the bright side.
Yeah. Not too bad, not too bad.
Interestingly, I was wondering if people watching the stream think that me and Simon sound related.
Where do you come from? Apart from my mother.
Apart from that, I come originally from Northamptonshire.
Oh, okay.
Which is just a bit north of you, but I'm currently living in Hampshire.
Ew.
Simon, if we can switch between Flyer and all this, maybe you should put on the video.
I thought we... Are we not? Yeah, we're still broadcasting. It's just...
Put on that the video thing. So
yeah, the video, actually, okay.
So the viewers can watch something.
Watch something. Sorry, I didn't... Because our factor for me is still showing in this as counting down, going through the live timing, and everything. It's very confusing. We'll try and...
I see the that's all I see.
Yeah, I know, that's all I can see, but...
Come on, Sam. Not like that.
Yeah, I know, I can... Yeah, all the cars are just... Ah, there we go, saving replay, yeah. Right, we will be back with you very shortly, because it's now actually crashed out to the menu. So once it's saved, it's epic replay. Yeah! See, it was all planned. Oh, okay. But no, I'm having never come across it before, I will ask my mother and just see whether or not I do have a bastard child. Well, not me, myself, I'm having a bastard child. Oh my god! I came out the room, I was like, right, let's get jiggy.
Well, interestingly, according to your Facebook profile,
that
we do have a 10-year age difference.
Oh. So it is technically quite legally possible. Or well, if I'd have matured. Are you, which way are you, up or down?
Down.
I feel so old.
I'm only 17, bless me.
What? Oh! But you have such vast knowledge on games and shit.
Well, you see, I also don't have any friends. So it's
it's giving me it's all good.
Time to learn things.
Do you know what? Friends are so overrated.
They are. I completely know where you're coming from. That's what I tell myself to make it feel better.
As you lull yourself to sleep at night.
Yeah, exactly. No, I don't know. It's just one of the things that I'm interested in. I'm interested in about two things.
What's the other thing?
Racing.
So I suppose sim racing is your ultimate orgasm of life.
Yeah. Pretty much. I mean, it's my ideal thing.
So really, yeah, I know, that's great. That's great. We'll be back with pictures very, very shortly. Ta-da!
We
are back live. We'll just jump in. Now, the problem that we're going to have with this, there will be no more timing banners across the bottom of the screen now, I'm afraid. So, the lap time counter won't work either. So it's going to be an interesting one. I will give it that.
We have to restart the stream.
Yeah, 35 minutes we're going. Kevin Ledoux is into the pits from 9th position because he's lost his front splitter. So he's had a war while all that was going on. Let me just jump into that. That's what I'll do is I'll go for a proper rundown of the order in a second. Why is that not going to change? It's because we're on spectator mode. Oh, this is going to be drama llamas. Right. Okay, so that will still go like that. Right, give me a minute or two just to reconfigure what on earth is going on in the world.
Wow.
Sky! Right, that's where I am. So do I have to cycle through, I wonder?
Fortunately, I've got no idea how R-Factor broadcasts work.
I did, but it's just having a fit. Right.
Try pressing 1 and 2, Sam. On the top numbers.
Come on. Yeah, it's just it's not
Is a 1 and 2 is supposed to be the controls for changing cars?
Quite sure.
Or you can press plus and minus on the numpad.
That is what I'm going to have a go at doing.
Yeah.
Sorry, I was getting a bit confused myself.
No,
it won't let me do that either. Oh, Roy, my friend. What kind of spin was that?
It's so busy, plus.
That's even more epic failing than we are at the moment.
How's he spun there?
That's exactly... It was like a... wibble wobble.
The front left of the car stuck into the side of the curb, I think.
P1 cars are just so quick. I would be scared to be doing the driving. I really would.
Lost quite some top speed down the straight now, I see.
Could someone else give this a little go? Because it doesn't seem to like my numpad or the plus and minus keys or anything, so I don't know if it's just the fact that I am using a keyboard from last century, a millennium, just to see whether it's just me being cack. That'd be awesome. I'll just take you through the rundown of the order just while we're sorting out problems here. So apologies for this. Rickard Helston is still leading for Torrent Motorsports on lap 171. And we've got the last 3 hours now left to go here at RD LMS for this 12-hour race at Le Mans. Second is Peter Enders for Atlantic Racing Team. He's 2 minutes 28 now. Oh, someone's changing something. How are you doing that?
I pressed the numbers.
See, it wouldn't do it for me.
You might have the wrong someone in the pit.
I'm not set up for juicy dramas. Third is Ryan Mayfield for 05 Motorsports. Excuse me. And that's him on our screens just at the moment there. He's two laps down. Fourth is Sergei Soldatov for Akuri Sim Motorsports. There he is. Just a lap behind. Still also two laps off the pace, sliding the car quite dramatically there. Fifth, Andre Martins for Atlantic Racing Team, exiting the pit lane. Five laps adrift, very much on their own now, Atlantic Racing Team, after all of their dramas. Sixth is Brandon Kaczmarek, leading the P2 class for R4R Motorsports. Doing a good job there.
Great camera.
I know. Look at me, there's a grassy verge. Seventh is Attila Kish for Simco Hungarian Team. He is nine laps adrift, one lap behind Brendan Kaczmarek. Eighth is Magnus Dahlgren for ME Racing. 10 laps adrift, third overall in the P2 category. Gregory De Greef is ninth for the Black Rebels P2 category. 12 laps adrift from our leaders. 10th is Wayne Reed, Total Sim Racing. Lap 156 is completing 15 off the pace. Roy Magnus has just moved up into 11th position for RMI Motorsports, despite that spin. So he's ascending the order quite nicely, but that's because David Grunvels is in the pits for SRH Zeno M in 12th place, that black and blue car. Looking pretty set in stone there. And that's the Schroten brothers about to go through in 13th position to overtake Grunvels as well. Now that's actually a battle more for real positions. Remco de Wild has taken over that Zeno car. So Roy up to 13th position. Remco now to 15th position for 05 Motorsports. Leading a GT2 category is Wilfried van Brink. Back in the car. Still absolutely blasting away and starting his 148th lap, or 147th, sorry. Richard Blocker is in the Rare Endurance Team, 15th position, 26 laps off the pace, just a lap behind Wilfried van Brink, and not an entire full lap either, so doing well there, a Rare. 16th, Marcel Persch for World Connect Competition. GT2, third overall in their class, 26 laps adrift. And Steve Davis is in 17th for 25 Motorsports in GT2, on the same lap as Marcel Persch, and not dramatically a million miles away either, so potential for a scrap there. 19th, because Casper Mortensen has retired with engine failure, is Marcel Vischer for Downforce Racing, 28 laps adrift. GT2. Simon Milewicz is back in the Total Sim Racing car, 30 laps adrift, just starting his 143rd lap now. And in 22nd place, and the last runner, is Stephen Poobles for LSD Racing, 33 laps adrift.
I can select him.
I've got him still flipping along, but you know, he will eventually. He's got one more lap to go, and then he'll go past the I fell asleep in the middle of the race, Stephen Miller, which has actually now come up as an engine failure for his retirement. So,
yeah, he might have stood as long that the engine overheated. That's, I actually can't choose Stephen Buble's hair.
How strange, not to worry. Is that Torrent Motorsport car missing something from the front?
It looked like that.
I don't know, Rickard, how...
Lost. Okay, what am I doing now? There.
Oh no, it's back. It just... Oh! Whoa, ho, ho, ho!
Me and my magic fingers. And going back live, it
that
looks
could
like...
very well... Yeah!
This. Oh, I'm
Rickard,
the master.
You are the master of disaster, by the looks of it, because oh. Rickard Helston, you've caught the magic moment, has potentially really compromised his race lead now. He had 2.5 minutes advantage over Peter Enders. They'd pretty much soldiered and tied up the victory. And suddenly, it's all looking a little bit different and better now. Peter Enders
in the pits.
Yeah, Peter Enders is just taking out the pit, coming out of the pit lane to take over the Atlantic Racing team. As Rickard Helston continues on without a front splitter, he's got the magic... mirrors. Not looking good. Oh, somebody's at the door. I'm going to go and grab my curry. I'll be back with you shortly. If you could take over for a smidgeroo.
Good try. Well, interesting now is if Anders is able to catch up with him down the streets. Or actually, I think Helston is about to catch Anders.
Yeah, the front coming off these LMPs has caused him tons of trouble all race long.
But I think it's more likely that Helston is catching Anders than Anders is catching Helston, because they're on the same straight, but Anders is first on the street.
I guess everyone needs to have problems in a race, especially one that's 12 hours long.
Yeah.
Even the leaders at some point, and you know, they had a healthy lead. I don't know.
One has a flawless race. Oh,
yeah.
Did you see how close they are? That's the same camera angle.
Yeah. It's in shot, isn't it? They can see each other. But am I right in thinking that the number 8 is... if the Helston driving the other car caught up to him, that would put the number 8 a lap down?
Yeah. If the Torrent Motorsport car catches Anders, he's a lap behind him. Where is Anders? Anders is there. No, that's the wrong number. Sorry. there.
And then... so if the Torrent Motorsports car went and repaired all their damage, they would, well, they'd close up the gap for the lead.
It's over 2 minutes. It's almost 3 minutes now. So...
yeah.
It would be hard.
Would be, I guess it also depends on which drivers they have driving for these last few hours.
Yeah. If Petter Kolsa is going back into the Torrent Motorsport car, I actually think he will maybe be able to catch them. Even with almost a minute pit stop with driver swap. There goes Anders down straight, and Helston go into bits.
So I guess that will be the full repair, tyres, refuel, driver swap.
It would be the smart thing to do, but we'll see. To see if they threw a driver swap on it.
The driver swap system for RFAX seems a bit more about the world is precarious than in other Sims.
Buggy sometimes, but yeah, they have no as well. Petrical says no back in the car. But I can't see any what happened? I forgot to switch on repair car?
That car's still broken.
That's quite stupid, because when they switch drivers, they fix the car completely. I have to go back into the front litter back on the P1 car, that's not very good.
Well, that could be the opening that the other guy back in second needs to make a bit more up. It's still a very tough challenge for them to get in front, but
yeah,
Barrett Motorsports opening the doors.
Okay. And there's on the lower part of the straight now. Going into the last corners. Oh no, he's way past the last corners. And where is... There is Torrent. Wow.
But there may well be a fight in the last hour or so.
It's too bad we can't see how far they are apart now. I could use the live timing, but I don't have it open.
I could go and fish for the link again, which I've gone and lost. It'll be somewhere. There we go. See if this works for me.
It should.
It should do. Looks like the right site as well, so I'll have a look. Loading something or other.
I know it's really un-PC to say, but I'm slightly disappointed when an Indian doesn't deliver the Indian man finger food to the door.
Well, you've been on. We had some action here.
Oh, so what happened?
Well, Torrent Motorsport went in his pits after almost catching PJ Anders down the straight. But they made a drive up and they didn't fix the car.
Oh!
They're still driving around with no front bumper.
Yeah. Peter Kasser went and... Well, not Peter Kasser, obviously. He's only just got in the car, but they've gone and lost... they've gone and lost a minute to... for the second place. Just by doing that pit stop. And it looks like they're losing more time as well.
How far behind head is he now?
Now I've it's only 2 minutes.
Yeah, 1:59.
Yeah, that's the same it was about an hour ago, so...
And then they're still losing time because they've not got a front splitter.
Yeah. Well, Pepper is a fast driver, so he might be able to pull it off anyway, but he needs a front bumper.
Yeah, I don't know, I can't see the second sector. There we go.
I'd rather switch cameras here, but...
Yeah, there we go. In the second sector of lap 17.
Oh, he's lost 3 seconds.
Yeah, there are 3 seconds in that sector alone, and it looks like that's the shortest sector of the lap anyway.
Yeah, it's 10 to 156.259, the gap between first and second. I think we could well have some high-octane action on our hands for the lead. Wow.
Yeah. Well, you've got to think there's either going to be that action later in the race, or Casa needs to go in and change the nose, which will bring the bike together anyway.
Is going wide through the corners.
See, now I'm getting into the actual commentary side.
Loving your work. Keep doing it. I'm stuffing the gob. Nice hanging bargy, by the way, Yano. Thanks.
How's the fruity... whatever it was that I decided to order you. Or get you to order would probably be better.
I've not gone for that, actually. I've gone for the... It's arrived with a little side of Bombay mix, so I'm stuffing that with my bargee and a little bit of pretend salad.
I wish I had a proper Indian like that near me.
Why do you... Are you like out on the sticks?
No, not really. There's just not a proper, you know, deliver Indian anywhere nearby. Bit upsetting, really. Quite like an Indian.
Oh.
You got a feel for him.
You've got that tone in your voice which makes me think sad panda.
I am a sad panda. That's actually my secondary occupation, apart from being a student.
The gap's now down to 1 minute 50.
And there goes the headlights of Petr Kosta. He's going back into the pits. Perfect camera.
You're all seeing it about 10 seconds before I do, so I'm having to watch the stream.
Let's see if he goes into the pits this time. Bye. Yes, he does.
Straight into the pits.
This is getting quite interesting. We see Petr Kosta goes into the pits.
It sounded like someone in an auction room just then.
Yeah.
You should have started going saying numbers at random.
Off your screen, Remco De Wilde has just passed Roy Magnus, because Roy Magnus is in the pits as well, as you can see on the screen. Okay, and Ryan Neafield is also in for 05 Motorsport in third position. Helston's still stationary. He'd lost another 3 seconds in that split, down to 1 minute 47. So it is all to play for.
Helston has taken over the wheel from Kosa.
This may be a bit off topic, but further down in the field, it looks like this is for third position in GT2. Steve Davis is catching Marcel Hirsch, and that looked like it's for position to me. But
it is. It is for position.
Someone's gone.
Someone's gone?
Spun.
Spun.
Sorry, you're all lagging out. I can't hear what you're saying, sorry.
Oh.
Well, Marcel Fischer is 2 laps behind Steve Davis, so that's not a battle for position.
Is it not?
No,
it is.
He's
it
got
is.
Marcel Persch just up ahead. Oh, sorry, it's two Marcels.
I said Persch. I hope I said Persch. That's what I meant.
It lagged out for me, so I only heard Marcel.
Oh, you
so
only
when
heard
I saw
Marcel.
Marcel Fischer, there's too many Marcels.
Yeah, I'm referring to Persch. Steve Davis has been catching him the last couple of laps.
Awesome-osaurus. I'll keep an eye on the gap lead, but I don't think that will be changing any time soon. So here comes Steve Davis onto the back of Marcel Persch.
One of Davis is catching first, might be because of the traffic.
So
I've watched Simon Mellowish, is what Persch is caught up to. So he'll get out of the way quite nicely. We've got Brandon Warren in the room, actually. How are you doing, Brandon?
I'm doing great.
We are loving your work. Persh's in the pit. So Steve Davis takes over third overall in a GT2 class because Persh is in the pits. Let me see if Davis has just recently pitted or not. Just jump onto that.
He did.
No, he's...
Not too long ago.
Yeah, lap 144 he pitted, so they're a bit split on the strategy, actually, by 6 or 7 laps. So that's interesting to see how that will come towards the end of the stints, because obviously if you're pitting every 20 laps, that could be spread out quite nicely by the time we get round towards the bottom end of the race.
Simon, man, I'm waiting. You know, I told you when I was done with my stint, you're gonna rap me a happy birthday song.
I told you to work on it and everything.
Seems like you're not gonna deliver. Kind of like the Indians.
I call mom and everything.
Once I've eaten, I'll get my mojo on.
That. Would fine. Yeah, I have to do it. I don't know if anybody wants to hear that.
Well, no, I need to go to my bedroom to get some musical instruments out. Like a flute or something.
Watch this.
Oh!
Oh no.
Moment.
Is that Mayfield? Larson?
Nope. Ah, from the... Just a moment. Ah.
How is it Enders?
I ruined it.
Is it? They're not going backwards anymore. That's good.
No. It was Jan Laan who drove off track.
Okay. He's only not long been in the car. How cold are these tyres when you start a stint, I wonder? Because people do seem to struggle.
65 degrees.
Okay. So is it really, really noticeably a real pain to get going around the first lap or two?
GT2 cars, by the end of the first lap, just going into the middle of the second lap, you've got a good feel for the car at that point. Or at least you should.
Because so many people have just spun on, like, their second lap round. It's really weird.
Well, it might have been playing with tire pressures, not the state time, or using a softer compound. You just got caught out.
Okay.
That's it.
For instance, at nighttime we use the soft, we use the super softs as opposed to the softs, and it's helped us out.
What's the logic behind that?
The logic behind it? Well, colder temperatures at night. You want to, have tires that can, maintain temperature at all times, and the super softs can do that. We at first were debating whether or not just to drop pressures dramatically and still use the soft tires, but it just wasn't worth it at the end, and the super softs worked quite well for us, and we were able to get faster times that way.
Okay.
Probably made a second and a half difference for me.
Wow.
Yeah. Except, which was going pretty good, until the end, my video card decided to, start rubbing up on my sound card. I guess I shouldn't install them so close together. It made a god-awful noise, and, when you have, like, a giant buzzing sound from your PC with 5 laps to go, and, you're trying to yell at your roommate who's a DJ, and he's, listening to his dubstep, and he can't even hear you. Trying to get him to diagnose what's going on, so he goes over here, and I'm trying to drive, he's right next to me, we're arguing about what's going on, and meanwhile, I'm surrounded by traffic, so it was very interesting. I was significantly slower at the end of my second stint.
I couldn't possibly imagine how. Gold.
It had to happen.
You've done well. Just to clarify, because there's someone asking about in chat. We were disconnected from the server, so the clock will constantly now show 0 for the next 2.5 hours. So don't panic, the race isn't over.
We have to restart the stream.
Oh yeah.
We have gone past the time space continuum.
Yeah. This race is that awesome. Exactly. We've still got 20 teams left though, so we're bang on the money. With 2.5 hours left to go, Kevin Cox will soon overtake Casper Mortensen in 3 minutes' time to take that 20th slot.
Oh,
so that's great.
That was a shot.
I'm going to make a prediction, guys, before I go. I predict that World Kinect Competition, we're going to get that podium spot. That's going to be ours.
Ooh.
Oh, I know. Laying it down.
Showdown.
Hours to go.
Oh yeah.
What's he up to? And you will notice that we're the only GT2 car that has our hood, so hey.
Yeah, but you see, that's not helping you because the other teams have figured out it's a competitive advantage to take away the weight of the bonnet.
I know. In fact, we should penalize them. Well, I think we should penalize them. Everybody's got to go in for about, I don't know, you know, stop going out, at least two of them each, and allow us to lead. Actually, first place is, what, six laps ahead of us? Yeah, 30-minute time penalty or something like that.
Make it an hour.
It's only fair. I don't make up the rules. You know, it's out of my hands.
Well, I'm sure that the admins will consider your views briefly and then move along.
Yeah, yeah. You know, once they see that I'm right, they'll be like, oh my god, there's no arguing this. I was thinking 45-minute time penalty. I was being nice.
Everybody in the chat box, raise your hand if you want the 30-minute penalty. I'll count. Anyone?
No? Come on, guest. No. Okay. I'm watching you.
It's dropped. Sorry.
However,
there's a little bit of lag time. Come on now. So how's the race been on your guys? It's been very exciting to commentate. I hear there's been a good battle for first for P1.
Well, the best battle we had so far is which movie is best.
Predictions game? Let's play predictions. I think we know who's going to win at GT2, but what about the other classes?
I actually think Torrent is going to win the PM. He won.
I think Torrent have got the win. They're back to holding the gap now, so... Albeit only 50-odd seconds.
A lot can happen.
Gap is quite big between the two leading cars in the P2 category as well, so for the moment it looks like the Alfa Romeo Sport car has at least one hand on the prize.
Oh, let's see. Luca and Lewis. Alright, time penalty. It's done. So that's World Kinect competition. First place, GT2. Oh yeah.
Booyah.
I'm assuming
and just
we
like
the
that.
Race.
Oh, that's a great shot. I love it.
Yeah, if I can't beat him with your driving, I'll beat him through penalties.
Yeah, lots of cars on that lot. A whole lot of nothing.
I'm very confused. Sorry, I've just been coming back, but I just looked in the chat room. There is actually a live broadcast of a game, followed by like a slightly confused smiley face. How on earth did you manage to get on this website to start with, to then try and bitch about it anyway? I'm very confused. Yes, you do fail, Luca. Sorry, mate. Sorry. That's really bad.
The okay, witty response would have been, no, this is a broadcast of EastEnders. What does it look like? Of course it's a broadcast of a game.
Gosh, you British people are so mean.
Look, it's because we've got nothing else to do with our times. We've just got to be mean and commentate on games. Literally our jobs.
You just lost the band. You just look at that. He's destroyed.
We don't mean it, Luca. We're just on edge because we've been doing... Well, I say we. Simon's been doing this for 10 hours. I've been watching it. I've not been talking.
I got your back, Luca. Don't worry. I don't even know these guys.
Move on. Nothing to see.
We're just disturbing Simon. He's eating his dinner.
Which is the blood of small children.
While I play with this BA toy. Dull.
I feel ashamed to know you. Cheers, Bab. Oh, wow.
How is the distance now for the, what is it, sixth position in... do.
Oh, I'm not sure, to be honest.
Because both the Schroten car, the SRH Center car, and the RMI car are on the same lap. They've been changing position back and forth now, all through my stint. Two.
2 seconds.
Yeah.
Overall?
There's only 10 seconds actually between the Schroten car and the SRH NO car.
Give me up, Scotty.
I'll choose the car.
Let's see. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, click. On. Yeah. 3, 4.
Come on, everybody. Let's learn how to count with fucking.
Screw you.
You guys been
was doing? Anyone else slightly stabbed with that?
Possibly. I think it might be worth it because you're rating.
This curry isn't very fruity, by the
way. Is it not as fruity as was advertised?
No, it has fruit in it.
But it's not fruity.
Not really, no.
Are in a battle.
It hasn't tried to love me up a little bit, I must admit. Is that a real battle on screen?
That's a real battle.
Oh my god, is it going to go down on the floor? Hang on.
I'm not sure, but
are you sure?
I don't think it is.
Because Eddie Holgren is
two laps
ahead of Gregory the Griff.
He is, yeah. Holgren's on 170, Griff's 160.
I just switching cameras.
Don't you love it when one things just come together?
Okay.
Now we're with the Schrotten.
Okay, this is Schrotten. And here comes Remco de Wild. It is Schrotten. It's only 9 seconds apart.
Not that far away, and Remco did take place behind the wheel of that car. I have timing thing.
Fresh.
Might be changing the gaps at every lap rather than every sector.
Oh, we're close now.
Yes, doesn't look like it.
Let's see if I try to do that. I choose the correct car, don't I? Schroten, yeah. And then I do like this.
I figured out what happened to Marcel. He was hitting a bunch of curves.
Oh.
So you have damage now, and it's causing trouble.
How do I switch the cameras to go back?
Ooh!
Hello?
Where's the camera?
I think it's so cool that his glasses are moving the car.
It's got what?
You have a play portal.
Oh, okay.
I see what you mean. I see what you did there.
I am going to be heading now, guys. Thank you for the commentating. I'll tell you how my step is going and stuff. It's time to celebrate my birthday. Hopefully by winning. good times. You guys have been drinking a little bit too much.
I have not drank anything. I'm just like a small
smoking a little bit too much of that reefer. Wait a minute. I'm American, right? So I need to like thank all my sponsors. But well, I'd like to thank Pepsi Cola and Chewy this car and God at the same time. God first, then Pepsi Cola. Wait, like the Cheerios, then
Baby Jesus.
Oh, Jesus, baby. Gotta be baby Jesus. You know, Seven out, baby Jesus.
British it's okay out. Because you're American, if you so you're chip, allowed to make fun of yourself.
If you see Chip, I will come at him like a spider.
And the preacher Simon, for preaching his good in conversation.
Ugh, I'm rubbish.
Nick Roland. Well, we got both media staff at racedepartment.com here.
What up?
Everybody says. I can actually see two cars on the screen, but the car in between there is Wayne Reed, who is actually, what is it, five laps up. What is it, fifth position in D2. So the gap between Goodwilt in seventh and P2 and one of the Schrotens. Next is that's 10 seconds, but I don't think it's that much.
We have to restart.
Has Helston had a problem?
Yeah. He first lost the front bumper.
Driver swap.
Forgot to switch to a new front bumper. So had to pit again.
No. I mean recently. Recently. He just lost 4 seconds, according to my lifetime.
Let's see.
I'm not sure, like, the lifetime doesn't seem to be telling me much that's useful. But it looks like he just pulled away and then, ooh, what's that? It's just DNF as well.
Oops. I don't see it in my game. I am breaking George's rule of not spectating on the server. Well, in the interest of broadcast, so.
Oh, not yet.
There's Enders, I think.
I got everybody running in my game. False alarm.
Yeah, it's my bad. I'm just going off the live timing, and that's telling me all sorts of things.
Well, here's,
but if we should restart broadcast, we should probably do it now.
Yeah, I know. I just want to check.
Well then.
So we'll be back with you in a minute then.
Just a moment. Unless you're on YouTube, then we'll take about.